light and peace in Jesus Christ our Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join me in the collect for light. Almighty God, we give you thanks for surrounding us as daylight fades with the brightness of your Vesper light, and we implore you of your great mercy
that you hold us
in the radiance of this life, so you would shine into our hearts the brightness of your Holy Spirit, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Old Testament lesson is from Exodus, the 6th chapter. Then the Lord said to Moses, "Now you shall see what I will do to Pharaoh. Indeed, by a mighty hand he will let them go. By a mighty hand he will drive them out of his land." God also spoke to Moses and said to him, "I am the Lord. I appeared to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob as God Almighty, but by my name, the Lord, I did not make myself known to them. I also established my covenant with them to give them the land of Canaan, the land in which they reside as aliens. I have also heard the groaning of the Israelites, whom the Egyptians are holding as slaves, and I have remembered my covenant. Say therefore to the Israelites, 'I am the Lord, and I will free you from the burdens of the Egyptians and deliver you from slavery to them. I will redeem you with an outstretched arm and with mighty acts of judgment. I will take you as my people, and I will be your God. You shall know that I am the Lord your God, who has freed you from the burdens of the Egyptians. I will bring you into the land that I swore to give to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I will give it to you for a possession. I am the Lord.' Moses told this to the Israelites, but they did not listen to Moses because of their broken spirit and their cruel slavery. Then the Lord spoke to Moses, 'Go and tell Pharaoh, king of Egypt, to let the Israelites go out of his land.' But Moses spoke to the Lord, 'The Israelites have not listened to me. How then shall Pharaoh listen to me, poor speaker that I am?' Thus the Lord spoke to Moses and Aaron and gave them orders regarding the Israelites and Pharaoh, king of Egypt, charging them to free the Israelites from the land of Egypt. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
The New Testament lesson is from 2 Corinthians, the third chapter. Are we beginning to commend ourselves again? Surely we do not need, as some do, letters of recommendation to you or from you, do we? You yourselves are our letter, written on our hearts, to be known and read by all. And you show that you are a letter of Christ, prepared by us, written not with ink, but with the Spirit of the living God, not on the tablets of stone, but on tablets of human hearts. Such is the confidence that we have through Christ towards God. Not that we are competent of ourselves to claim anything as coming from us. Our competence is from God, who has made us competent to be ministers of a new covenant, not of letters, but of spirit. For the letter kills, but the spirit gives life. This is the word of the Lord. Please stand for the reading of the gospel. The gospel lesson is from Mark, the 10th chapter. As he was setting out on a journey, a man ran up and knelt before him and asked him, "Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" Jesus said to him, "Why do you call me good? No one is good but God alone. You know the commandments. You shall not murder, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not steal, you shall not bear false witness, you shall not defraud, honor your father and mother." He said to him, "Teacher, I have kept all of these since my youth." Jesus looked at him, loved him, and said, "You lack one thing. Go, sell what you own and give the money to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come, follow me." When he heard this, he was shocked and went away grieving, for he had many possessions. Then Jesus looked around and said to his disciples, "How hard it will be for those who have wealth to enter the kingdom of God." And the disciples were perplexed at these words. But Jesus said to them, Children, how hard it is to enter the kingdom of God. It is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for someone who is rich to enter the kingdom of God. They were greatly astounded and said to one another, "Then who can be saved?" Jesus looked at them and said, "For mortals it is impossible, but not for God. For God all things are possible." Peter began to say to him, "Look, we have left everything and followed you." Jesus said, "Truly I tell you, there is no one who has left house or brothers or sisters or mother or father or children or fields for my sake and for the sake of the good news, who will not receive 100-fold now in this age. Houses, brothers and sisters, mothers and children and fields with persecutions, and in the age to come eternal life. But many who are first will be last, and the last will be first." This is the word of the Lord.
Let us ask of the Lord.
Let us pray. Covenanting God, you have established an everlasting relationship with your people. By your mercy, you have bound yourself to us, and you hear the cries of your people. Grant us deliverance from the chains that hold us back from you. Melt our hearts of stone, and give us new hearts that are filled with your Spirit. We bring before you all who have yet to find freedom in our world today. Be with those who find themselves entrapped by the oppressive systems of human trafficking, child soldiers, and various forms of economic injustice. Speak words of comfort to those who are still in exile. And be with the people and the agencies who seek to break these bonds of slavery. May our hope ever rest in your promises to always remember. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving God, who knows us even better than we know ourselves, you speak into our lives and write on our hearts the story of your abounding love. Help us in our struggles to love one another and teach us to hold on to your everlasting love and grace. Give us confidence when we feel as though we are weak and that our love and patience have run out. And comfort all those whose hearts have been broken by a relationship, the loss of a loved one, the loss of a home, or the loss of employment. We pray that you would be especially with the families in Aso, Oregon, who continue to search for missing family members and neighbors in the wake of a devastating landslide. Grant your mercy upon those who continue to search for the Malaysian Flight 370, and comfort and draw near to those families of the lost. And we ask, dear Lord, that you would draw near to the students and teachers and staff at Franklin Regional High School in Pennsylvania, who are disoriented and scared by the recent school attack. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God, who forever rests on the side of the poor, teach us the hard lessons of trusting too much in our material wealth. In the Gospel of Mark, we are reminded of the rich man who went away grieving, because he cannot give up the things that you require of us to follow you. When we are possessed by our very possessions, teach us to be generous with the gifts that you have given to us, and remind us that everything we have is from you. We bring before you all who live on meager wages and daily must choose between paying for rent or paying for food. Help us to see those who cannot afford to see. Open our eyes to those who are needy and hungry around us in Raleigh, Durham. Grant us compassion and care for those agencies who feed, clothe, and care for those who are without life's most basic necessities. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We are bold to pray the prayer that Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
Our worship has come to a close, but we go out into the world. And may the blessings of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen.